We're here at Shenandoah Valley High School. I'm with Owen Kozar, three sport athlete here, right?
Yep.
I didn't want to make sure I didn't forget anything else, playing football, baseball, and also basketball. We'll talk about all that, but let's start with your latest accomplishment, 1,000 points in your career in basketball. Talk about achieving that, checking it off early in your senior year. You get have a few days now to let it sink in. Talk about your 1,000 point a little bit.
It's been something I always wanted to do since my freshman year of high school. And to achieve that goal in a must-win game against Marion, with the huge crowd, it couldn't really be any better.
Was there a moment to at least give you a congratulations and everything?
Yeah, I mean, it couldn't happen at a better time. We came back, and I think it actually tied the game, or we might have actually took the lead there, but it couldn't happen at a better time.
1,000 point, you guys are off to a hot start this year. How confident as a group are you guys right now?
Well, we're pretty confident. You know, I've been playing with these kids since fourth grade. I mean, we all stuck together. And I think that's kind of what's brewing for us right now. We're so used to playing with each other, and we're just going to keep playing. Hopefully the success keeps going.
You've been playing with them for a while. Was there a moment on the playground, bitty bit something, where you thought, hey, this group, we might be able to do something special on the basketball
court? Yeah, I told this group of kids, you know, if we stuck together, this is my freshman year, you know, we took our lumps our freshman and sophomore years, but I told them if we keep sticking together, we're going to have a good basketball team our junior and senior year.
How hard is that to do, to take your lumps, to take the losses, keep people together and say, hey, listen, we're going to get through this?
It's hard to do, but it makes you better as a player. It makes you better as a team. And, you know, you learn as it goes on.
It's a lot of joking when I arrived here. I mean, you guys, it's that kind of friendship. You guys, it seems like a family.
Yeah, it is. Like I said, I grew up playing backyard football with these kids almost every day. Same with basketball. You know, we hung out pretty much every day throughout the summer.
Growing up, I mean, you're an outstanding athlete here. I mean, were you always doing, like, every sport? What was, like, your first sport? How'd you get into all this?
I don't know. You know, I'm from a small school, so I just figured I'll play three sports. I still don't even know what my favorite sport even is yet. I just like playing sports. I don't know.
You're a senior, and I saw, like, in the standard speaker, you're thinking of continuing your career. Is there one you would, or are you just like, whatever happens, happens. I'll see where it goes.
Yeah, I'm kind of between baseball and football right now, but I don't know.
What do you want to do post-college?
I want to do something in the medical field. I'm not sure what exactly yet.
Why is that?
I just want to help people. Well, I was thinking something like maybe even like a sports trainer, because I'm always around sports and everything, so I think that'd be pretty cool.
Football here at Shenandoah Valley, trying to build it back up over the past few years. How far do you think you've come from your freshman year to now in helping build up the program?
I mean, we came a far way. I mean, you look at the last 5 years, you know, I think they went 0-10 almost every season. And this year we came out and we won two games, but we also competed with like every team, so I couldn't be more happy.
Yeah, so positive direction. I feel you guys laid a good foundation for what's to come. Football career, give me a highlight. I know you've had so many, but when I say that right now off the top of your head, what was the highlight of your football career?
Probably personally, when we beat Panda Valley this year. I think there was 20 seconds left on the clock, and I ran it in for a touchdown, and we won the game.
Who are you throwing to a lot? Was it Joey?
Joey Vasis, yeah.
Yeah, okay, got it. Talk about that relationship a little bit.
Once again, one of my best friends, hang out almost every day, and we grew up playing backyard football, and we just have that relationship. We just click together.
I forget who it was, but they said you only struck out once in baseball last year.
Yeah.
True. How frustrated were you after that one strikeout?
I was a little frustrated, but I'm also like, well, I guess it's just one strikeout, so it's not too bad.
Away from sports, are you doing anything else, or is this just pretty much take up all of your time?
I hunt and fish a lot.
Is that relaxing, or is that also competitive for you?
A little bit of both. I like to, you know, try and shoot a big deer or catch a big fish.
You get a deer this year?
Yeah.
Best fishing story. Do you have a good fishing story you could share with me?
Probably when we went to Delaware and we were shark fishing. Just crazy how big, how hard a fish could fight.
Who did you look up to as an athlete? Whether it was someone in town, whether it's a family, whether it's a pro. I mean, who do you kind of look up to?
Basketball-wise, when I was in like fifth, sixth grade, I looked up to Joel Santana, which he was the last person to score 1,000 before me. So I looked up to him.
That Shenandoah Valley basketball practice featured a lot of talent, confidence, and jokes. This is a tight group of Blue Devils who think they can accomplish big things this season. I talked with some of Owen Kozar's teammates and his coach to learn more about their hot start and their expectations. What do you think defines this year's team?
I mean, just gritty. We're just a really gritty team. I mean, we're not afraid to do the stuff that other teams are. Like, we'll get on the floor, we'll take charges, and I mean, Coach Miller's just preached defense, and I think that's really our identity this year, where we're just going out, and we want to beat you on the defensive end, and we want our defense to create offense and kind of let us get out and run in transition.
What's your defense like this year? How would you describe it?
Full court pressure, forcing guys offhand, just playing all up and down.
That sounds tiring. You say you're out of wind right now, I mean, but it sounds like a tiring thing to do.
Out of wind, taking charges, moving with the ball, loose balls, diving on the floor, everything.
You guys take a lot of pride in that.
Yeah, we take a lot of pride in our defense.
What's your first memory of playing with this group of seniors?
We were playing together as freshmen and all that, and we actually had a good freshman group. We lost, I think, 2 games that year, and we used to go out and just put up big numbers as a group, and it stuck from there, and we just try to continue that year in and year out.
Do you guys split up, like if you're playing on a playground and play against each other?
Yeah, we all play against each other, working hard on the playground. Gets really competitive.
Well, I'm a point guard. I mean, I look to pass first, get my teams open to put points on the board, and then sometimes I look for myself. This year, I look for myself a little bit more because, you know, they're all worried about Owen now, you know, because that's my man. So, yeah, I just attack the basket, and if I don't have it, I kick it out.
Early in the season, what's been a great pass you've had this year? Sure, can you share a sequence with me?
I want to say against Marion. Mm-hmm. I was driving in, and then 2 guys came in my face, and I looked the other way. I didn't see Nick Makita there, and I just dropped it off, and he just ended up in the right place.
To have that success, what do you guys have to do well this season? What's some stuff you guys really have to focus on?
I'd say more play as a team, play together. I think last year at times we were playing a little, you know, selfish, not so much selfish, just not as a team more. This year I think defense is really the key to it. Team defense has been really the key to our wins this season. I think we could keep building off that.
You say not being selfish. Is it just being out there and looking for other guys, or just having that feeling that, you know, other guys have got your back and you don't really have to worry, a little bit of bold?
I think more of that. Like, you mess up, you know, your teammates are going to be there for you, and, it, you know, not amplify your mistake even more. They'll cover you, you know what I mean?
Here for, you know, Owen just got his 1,000th point, but it seems like you have a number of other guys who are really, really talented on this team.
Yeah, we're well-rounded. There's not one guy on this team that you could leave alone. If you just focus on Owen, he's so unselfish that he'll let other people pick up the slack. So if Owen struggles, or if Owen's, you know, too focused on by the other team, we have guys that can step up and score 10, 15, 20 points. And that's what being a team's all about.